Respected Lalu Prasad Yadavji, respected Sri Rajdeep Sardesai, distinguished participants, invitees, friends, media, ladies and gentlemen. Just now you cautioned me only 5 minutes. Originally you told me 10 minutes. Now already 5 minutes cut. Now I am having prepared speech, but I have to implement his orders. Now I have to cut my speech. This is a very interesting subject. Power shift, will the states lead the center? We don't have any doubt about it. Already it is happening. Even in future, it is going to happen. There is no doubt about it. If you see in the first Lok Sabha, only all regional parties, 7 regional parties put together, they contributed 23 Lok Sabha seats at that time. And at the same time in 1967, Congress party was reduced to 303 seats. And also they lost power in 8 states. That was the beginning. DMK started in the second general elections only with 1 seat. Finally, 5th Lok Sabha, they have won 25 seats. TDP started in 83. 84 parliament elections, we have won 30 after Indira Gandhi's assassination. Telugu Desam played major opposition party role in parliament. First time in Indian history, one regional party has played as main opposition in the parliament. Even after, in 1989, if you see, Congress got 195 seats. All these things, it is a history. Since 1996, around 150 seats are contributing by regional parties. As Mr. Desai has rightly mentioned, if both national parties, Congress and BJP put together, they are just 275 seats in the 14th Lok Sabha and also 325 seats in 12th Lok Sabha. Even next election also, they may not increase its tally. It is 275 or less than 275. It is very clear. But if you see the scenario, political scenario, both parties are running the government at center by supporting other regional parties, either NDA or UPA, even tomorrow some alliance, all these parties are running with the regional parties only. Here I wanted to say one thing very clearly. After 1991, after economic reforms, if you see the post-economic reforms and pre-economic reforms, pre-economic reforms, there was only one party, Congress. At that time, there was no impressive growth. I am using this word, impressive growth. If you take into consideration post-reform period, P.V. Narasimha Rao, Congress government, at that time also not an option, with compulsion we have gone for reforms. From then onwards, all coalition governments, we are doing well because of economic reforms. Even states, if you see, Telugu Desam, we had a track record. Just now, he's saying CEO. CEO had its own problems also by giving that title for me. Even I have paid some price because I have seen long-term future of the state and also future of the country. We are responsible for some power sector reforms, IT promotion, airports privatization, even telecommunication. Singh was here, is here. From the beginning I am fighting. China, at that time, they used to add 2 million cell phones every month. Why can't India? Even just like these meetings, I used to promote very strongly all economic reforms and also deregulation. That is how it has happened. Even we used to create competition between states to states. I used to go to Davos, some other countries, some other states for requesting investment. generally all industries used to go to politicians. First time we have changed the trend. Politicians are going to industries for better investment. That is how we have promoted all these things. If you see here, even sometimes only one party domination, even at that time we had so many problems. Around between 52-87, president rule was imposed 75 times. They have misused 356 article more than 50 times. We are also victims for that. Even Telugu Desam was dismissed in 1984. With agitation again, we have come back. Today we are very clear, even NDA government or UPA government or UF government at that time, we never allowed to misuse Article 356. Even governors cannot play any politics. Only on the floor of the house, even all members, they will decide either in parliament or in assembly. That is how we insisted all these things. So it is very clear we need strong center. And at the same time, strong states should be there. Then only there will be balance. There are weak states with a strong center. Naturally, it will have a problem. Even weak center with strong states, there will be a problem. Future is very clear. India will be cooperative federalism. In that, states should have more powers. And at the same time, center also should be strong to control only some areas, foreign affairs, defense, railways, like that. Even our friend Laluji, he is doing very well in railway department. He hails from a regional party, but his contribution for railways is extremely good as on today. That is how all regional leaders, regional party leaders, they are having very good experience. If you see one thing in American politics and Indian politics, in the American politics, either governors or some state leaders are competing for presidential election. They are doing extremely well. Either anybody if you name, they have come from grassroots level experience. That is how things are happening. At the end of the day, we are very clear, even next election, both BJP and Congress, they may not get 50% of the seats. Naturally, all regional parties will be strengthened further. They will decide the future. As you rightly mentioned, I don't have an opposition, I am not an aspirant for that. Some regional leader will occupy the PM chair. I don't have any doubt about it. That day will come. But at the same time, what we are expecting, this economic reforms will continue. There is no doubt about it. And at the same time, the benefits of economic reforms should reach the common man. Today, we are seeing all economic crises all over the world. This is due to they are unable to have proper regulatory setup and also proper supervision of the concerned head of the governments. That is how it has happened. It is a matter of time. India, we are having some strength. At the same time, we are also having so many problems. All these problems, all politicians as regional party leaders or national party leaders, we are one to build the nation. That is how we are working together. With this, I am thanking all of you. Thank you. Thank you one and all.
Thank you, sir. May I now request the Union Railway Minister and the RJD Chief, Lalu Prasad Yadav, to take the stage. He has very clearly pointed out, Mr. Naidu, that he is no longer a regional party. He has been given the recognition of a national party. So he comes here, he says, is a very much a national party leader. Mr. Yadav.